policy is one which is called by an Afrikaans word apartheid. And I'm afraid that has been misunderstood so often. It could just as easily, and perhaps much better, be described as a policy of good neighborliness, accepting that there are differences between people. But while these differences exist, and you have to acknowledge them, at the same time, you can live together, aid one another, but that it can best be done when you act as good neighbors always do.
Ebongaza eminyaka engamashumi amabili nane elakulele lakhululwa ngaphansi kobugqila besandla senhlakahla ngaphansi kombuso wabebala.
We declare our right on this earth to be a man, to be a human being, to be given the rights of a human being, to be respected as a human being in this society, on this earth, in this day, which we intended to bring into existence.
There are a lot of studies that have shown that the vast, vast majority of people in this country, white and black, are not racist. Racism is a problem in South Africa, but it's a problem among the fringes. There are some white people who are really racist, and there are some black people who are really racist. But the opinion polls have shown that, and also you can practically experience it. When I go to a shopping center or to a taxi rank and I speak with black people, I don't experience them having negative emotions towards me. I can have a great conversation with them. So racism is a problem, but it's not as if the entire country is just infected with racism. So that's the first thing. But on the other hand, it appears as if the problem of racism is worsening in South Africa, especially in the last few years. And that's very relevant thinking about what happened in 1994. And I think part of the problem that we experience today has to do with the expectations that were created during the negotiations leading up to the election of 1994. And I think part of the problem there is that different messages were sent out to different communities. So for example, the National Party was largely a spokesperson communicating to the white community, and the ANC was largely a spokesperson communicating to the black community. I'm generalizing a bit, but the message that the National Party sent out about what the new South Africa would look like and the message the ANC sent out were to a large degree not reconcilable. What the National Party said to their followers, their supporters who voted that apartheid should end in the referendum of 1992, was that we need to change this system. The system is wrong. We need a better system. And we can guarantee to you that within a new South Africa, with a new constitution, there will be majority rule, but minorities will also be protected. So minority communities will not experience that they are threatened. They will not experience that their property is under threat. They will not experience that their language is under threat at university, education, and so forth. What the ANC said to their supporters was that once this happens, the era of oppression is over, and that which you believe is rightfully yours will be given back to you. And those two messages are not completely reconcilable with each other. And I think both groups, to speak in racial terms, are now disillusioned. So we have white people frustrated because they feel that they were guaranteed that their property would be protected as a minority community. And we have black people frustrated because it's been 24 years and they are still poor. They still live in poverty.
Ukwenyuka kwezigameko ngabantu abacwasana ngokwebala kanjalo nabantu izimpilo zabo ezingathuthukiswa ikakhulukazi kulabo abasahlala emkhokhweni bakhombisa ukulamukela leli khwela lokucakazwa komhlaba phakathi.
Arina di RDP houses. So nirikopa fela ha re kare molao or fe black ending ya rona re kgone aga re nke bana ba rona re tlo nna le bona le teng a sore house wa kontlu maybe. Maybe pilago e botlhoko or o tshaba some body control e o batla pleke ya gago lanka tlhokofala ka osane ke tso gore ke sile bana baka ko pleke ya bona
even though ba ka se re fetse tsa RTP ba re fa a land and a le toilet and a le electricity batla ba re kenyetsa yona we are prepared to move but if ever ba sa re fe land ba re tsa mai if ever is a fight they want we are going to fight for this
esifundazweni sa segole zakhamuze ziyaqhubeka nokuzitapela umhlaba ngaphandle kokugunyazwa.
There is a hunger for land, to use the term that President Cyril Ramaphosa used, but all the available research and all the available data indicates that there's not really a hunger for agricultural land. There's a hunger for urban land. And we can see that there are so many ways to in which you can indicate that. One of them is a recent study has shown that of all the land grabs happening in the last 5 years in South Africa, 84% of them happened in cities, in metropolitan areas. Also, we do know that 93% of people who have instituted land claims went and said during the process that they would prefer to have money as opposed to land.
Kunendida ngeqhaza elingadlalwa ubuqotho bomthethosisekelo ngokucakaza komhlaba obuyiselwa ebantwini kubanikazi. Yize noma ngalesi sinqumo sexubene imbono ngohulumeni osolwa ngokhudula izinyawo ngalolo daba. Injolabuchopho engumeli umnumzane uThembeka Ngcoka Intobe uthi umthethosisekelo uhlanakezelwe kodwa ikhona imfanto engasetshenziswa ukuncikisa leli khwela. Maqondana nokubuyekezwa komhlaba ukhangezwa abaphucwa abebaleli nsonto.
We are now, I think, 23 years after the 27th of April 1994.
Yes.
So it's a pivotal moment to reconsider because democracy is now at a mature age, if maturity is 21.
Yes.
To now reconsider whether or not the choices made then were the correct choices, and if they were not the correct choices, in what way they need to be rejigged in that way. So as you know, the land question is an important part of the constitution. In fact, in my own view, the land question is central to the constitution. The struggle for emancipation from colonial, imperial and apartheid rule was largely the struggle about land. And so the constitution was meant to be a response to colonial occupation. So at the heart of the constitution is then the resolution of the land question. It contains a clause, we usually refer to this as the property clause. It's in section 25 of the constitution. It already contains the parameters through which we can implement the land reform program. But the problem, of course, has not been the constitution. The problem has been the implementation of the constitution, largely through neglect on the part of the government. So the calls that have emerged recently, especially the call from the EFF, is a welcome call because it says to all of us we should wake up and recognize that the central clause of the constitution is yet to be implemented. And so from where I stand, I'm not particularly worried about illegality or violence because there is no need for illegality, there is no need for violence, because the instruments that we need for the implementation of the constitution are contained in the legal system. What we need is to simply put it into practice.
Listen here, This man shot that guy and he's my family. He came to vote here.
It is true that we have achieved some freedoms. We are able to vote. We are able to be employed in positions we couldn't be employed before. We are able to live in spaces that we couldn't occupy previously because of acts like the Group Areas Act. But freedom in its total sense, it was always linked to the return of what was dispossessed from African people. And freedom in its total sense was always linked to the idea of equality. And freedom was always linked to the idea of living a life of dignity. It was Nelson Mandela himself who said that there is no freedom with the socio-economic imbalances continuing to persist. Thabo Mbeki made the same point when he noted that South Africa was still a country of two nations, one white and wealthy, one black and marginalized and impoverished. So freedom is in many respects has arrived, but at the same time it is elusive.
Iqembu le-EFF selokhu langena emandleni njengeqembu eliphikisayo liyaqhubeka nokugqugquzela ukuthi umhlaba mawubuyiselwe kubanikazi.
Land expropriation without compensation is non-negotiable, is going to happen.
So what he's actually doing is he is encouraging people to commit crime. The land issue is of course a big issue. There's no denying that, and it's something that has to be dealt with. But encouraging people to commit crime in order to deal with a very sensitive political issue that has the potential of turning into a time bomb is very reckless, and it's something that we believe should be taken seriously, and I think our political leaders should be more responsible in the way in which they address these issues.
How do we heal this permanent anger amongst black people that even 24 years into democracy they're still very angry because the property relations have not changed?
I think that you can make a very strong argument that political leaders, especially very influential political leaders, are partly to blame for the crime crisis that we have in South Africa. And we see that within the ruling party and within, especially also within some of the opposition parties. So we've heard these comments made by the EFF, for example, and Julius Malema saying that if you see a piece of land that, and you like it, take it, it's yours.
Ngalezi iphelo zobandlululo namanje ziyaqhubeka nokugelezisa inhlasenzondo phakathi kwabantu abamnyama nabamhlophe. Okuyizinkomba zokuthi abantu bebalelinsondo namanje basalawulwa ngaphansi kwesandla sabamhlophe. Kulandela ukuthi basawaqokethe namandla esimo serandi. Alabutho yomculo we-jazz umnumzane uSipho Hotsticks Mabosa ugeqa amagula ethi kusazoba umqansa ukuphucula izimpilo zabantu ababisheshe obishini lohlupheko. Kulandela ukuthi mncane kakhulu umsebenzi owenziwe ngabantu abavotela izinguquko ngoboningi.
Umhla ka-27 April ilanga ekufanele silithokozele kakhulu. Number one, we need to celebrate that day because that day did not come easily. Langa ekufanele sizikhumbuze ngalo ukuthi impilo eziningi zalahleka ngale ngokulwela inkululeko yesizwe. The freedom that we are so celebrating on this day is such that we need to remind ourselves how many young people, how many people sacrificed their time, their lives, their families, in order that that day would come. So we should not underestimate the fact that E27 is an important day in our history.
Nizolilwela.
You know, forgiving and forgetting are two different things. You can forgive, but you must not forget. I think people must always be reminded of what apartheid meant to us, so that their level of consciousness is such that they admit to themselves, we erred. You know, apartheid was a scourge. Apartheid was a gross inhuman justice against armless people, right? So what are they going to do? We cannot admit good. We had nothing to offer.
UNgqongqoshe uNathi Mthethwa kuhulumeni ngaphansi komnyango wezobuciko namasiko uthi njengoba uhulumeni ekhuluma ngeyokubuyekezwa komhlaba ngenhloso yokulungisa amaphutha asala ngemuva ngezibhelo zobandlulula, kusemqoka ukuthi abantu bahlamule ngokulinganayo kule nkululeko eyavotelwa yintando yeningi.
Ubani ufuna ukukhokhelwa amademeshe ebekade ewuthenge ngamalini lo mhlaba? Uyabona kufanele siyibuze lowo mbuzo. La bantu bamademeshe bayahlupha ngoba bakhuluma ngamademeshe abangazange bakhulume ngawo ekuqaleni beduna umhlaba kubantu abaningi kulelizwe. Into esiyishoyo ukuthi asifuni abantu bahambe bayobhozomela nje umhlaba uphume wonke ubuntu wonke amabhoxongwane lawa abhozomela umhlaba, ngoba loo nto kuthiwa i-land grab. Sithi njengohulumeni sizokwakha uhlelo oluzokwenza isiqiniseko sokuthi abantu abadinga umhlaba ngendlela ehlelekile umhlaba uyabuyiselwa kubona ngale kokukhokha amademeshe evele okungafanele siwakhokhe ngoba ayengakhokhiwe kwasekuqaleni. Kodwa asiyukuvuma ukuthi umthetho, ngoba izwe lethu libuswa ngokomthetho, intando yeningi ebuswa ngokomthetho.
Safa saphele isizwe simnyama, iwa safa
isizwe safa
yamula mo
hanijani mbo kalize
wemhaye wemolo.
Isikhathi esikusona njengamanje uma ubheka emuva sisesikhathini esingcono kunala siphuma khona. Siphuma esikhathini esinzima ngaphambi nje kobandlululo. Ukudunwa komhlaba wabantu bakithi amakolonial ifika namthwalo ngeminyaka yo-1700 ila kwaqala khona inkinga, ngoba uma uzobuka ukuthi kwakwenzekani ngo-1913 kwase kuyiy'nsalela zomhlaba othathiwe loyo kubantu bakithi, uthathwa ngendlakadla. Izimpi ezaliwa ngapha eMpuma Koloni, ukwenza nje isibonelo, zazi abantu bakithi babelwela ukuvikela umhlaba wokhokho babo. Hambeke safika esikhathini sokuthi kuliwe manje sekungasaliwa ngeyikhali, sekuliwa ngeyinhlangano zombangazwe ezifana no-African National Congress osebenze kakhulu ekutheni uqwashise abantu ngezinto ey'ningi. Into yokuqala uqwashise abantu ngayo ukhongolose ebonakalayo kubantu bonke, imbala yayo umnyama, okuhlaza, satshani, kanye nalo oyigolide, okuchaza ke isimo sabantu base-South Africa.
UNgqongqoshe uNyambose waqokothisa ukuthi uhulumeni kusaphoqa ukuthi aqhubeke nokufinqa imikhono ngokuphuculwa kwezimpilo zabantu abebalensondo, kulandela ukuthi namanje basadonsa ngegiya lokugcina.
Namhlanje khona abantu abangenayo indawo yokuhlala eNingizimu Afrika, and labantu abangenayo indawo yokuhlala iningi labo abantu abamnyama. So labo bantu kufanele bacatshangelwe, akufanele bacatshangelwe uhulumeni kuphela. Yingakho sisho namanje ukuthi abantu abaziyo ukuthi banomhlaba abangawusebenzisi abeze ngaphambili kuhulumeni, kungaze kufikwe esikhathini sokuthi uyothathwa, ngoba bekufanele uthathwe uzothathwa bese unikezwa laba abawudingayo. njengoba uhulumeni ebhizi ney'nhlelo zokubuka isizwe nokubuka ukwentuleka komhlaba ukuze umhlaba ukwazi ukwabiwa kubantu, asizilandele lezo y'nhlelo zikahulumeni. Umhlaba lwesikhuluma ngawo awukwazi ukutapa njengathi utapa iy'nyosi, ngoba uma ngabe wenze njalo udala ususuthuthufa, ngoba uzosuka uthinte omunye umhlaba osizayo isizwe. Ngoba umhlaba la e-South Africa siyakubeka ukuthi owawo wonke umuntu owusebenzayo.
Njengoba uhulumeni nezinhlaka ezinqobe eMonyonga eyokubuyekezwa komhlaba osekuphakamisa ukuthi mawucakaze ukhangezwe abaphoxwa okungabantu bebalensondo, imbono namanje iyaqhubeka nokushayisana ngenjongo yokuthi ekugcineni kuzoba khona ukukhumelana umlotha.